Welcome to part 2 of our tutorial on rendering light fields from the Stanford Light Field Archive using the free and open source COLIBRI VR package for the Unity game engine. In the second part, I'll show you how to use the disk-based blending method implemented in COLIBRI VR to render our input images interactively with refocusing and view-dependent reflections. I'll be demonstrating the results both on desktop by moving a virtual camera around in the scene and game views, as well as on a virtual reality head-mounted display. The image-based rendering algorithm we'll be using here is a simpler version of the disk-based blending method demonstrated in the Welcome to Light Fields application. The general idea is to project each image into 3D space onto the corresponding focal plane, and blend the images together, adaptively and in real time, based on the viewer's current viewpoint. By modifying the focal length, that is, the distance separating the focal planes from the camera centers, we'll be able to refocus the light field on a different part of the object. By moving the virtual camera around, we'll also be able to observe view-dependent effects, here the specular highlights on the facets of the amethyst. To use this blending method, we're going to process our input data to create several virtual assets. So let's create an empty game object and add a processing component. Let's specify our amethyst folder, and then we'll indicate which virtual assets we want to process. So first, we're going to use a texture array that combines all of our input images. So you can click on Texture Array from Color Data. And second, we're going to use a quad mesh that will instantiate multiple times to create the focal planes of our images. So you can click on Purview Meshes from Underlying Focal Surfaces. We now launch Play Mode and click on Process Source Data and Yes on the pop-up. This processing step took about 4 minutes on my setup. We now have a processed data folder in our main folder that contains our processed assets. We can now exit Play Mode and click on Bundle Processed Data. This bundling step took about 3 minutes on my setup. We now have a bundled data folder in our main folder that can be loaded at render time. So to render these assets, we're now going to add a rendering component on top of our processing component. And here, as a blending method, let's select disk blended focal surfaces. Let's just leave the parameters to their default values for now and launch Play Mode. Upon launching the scene, this rendering component will load the asset bundle we just created and apply the selected rendering method. So if we look in the console, we first have to wait for it to load the bundle, and once this is done, the images are shown in the scene view in front of the corresponding cameras. If we change the focal length parameter, we can make these image planes go further out, and the rendering algorithm will make them blend together as they overlap. This is how we can refocus the light field, and this depends on the position of my virtual camera relative to the virtual capture setup, on the value of the focal length parameter here, and on the value of the blending angle. So I'll place my virtual camera close to the capture setup, set the blending angle to 60 degrees, and I'll remove the gizmos to make this clearer. So for instance, with this setup, if I put the focal length around a value of 0.04, each individual image is visible. Around a value of 7, the amethyst seems to appear, but nothing is in focus yet. Around a value of 30, the red pedestal of the amethyst here is in focus, while the rest of the object is still a bit blurred. And around a value of 100, the amethyst itself is in focus, while the pedestal is more blurred. And each time, I can move around by panning my camera in the scene view, and I'll get this effect of motion parallax, so the object seems 3D, even though it's just a set of image planes being blended together. And we have these view-dependent rendering effects, so the reflections on the facets of the mineral here. And this works in the game view as well, if you put your camera in the right spot. And I'll now demonstrate it in a VR headset. To make it easier to test all of this, I set up a demo scene, which you can import by going into Package Manager, Colibri VR, and for demo scenes, click Import into Project. And once this is done, go into Demo Scenes and click on Amethyst Demo. And under Environment, Amethyst in the rendering object here, specify the Amethyst folder. And for a blending method, select Disk Blended Focal Surfaces. And then, with VR enabled and your headset on, just launch Play Mode and wait for the asset bundle to load. And once this is done, you can now see the Amethyst light field in virtual reality. We've now reached the end of this tutorial. Thank you for watching. As always, feel free to give us your feedback on the project's GitHub page, and hopefully see you for the next tutorial.